Prominently placed and operational CTC panel can be quite an attraction in any model railroading room. Unfortunately, building one requires wiring a lot of switches and lamps, so many model railroaders hesitate to build one. Today, I am going to show you how you can build a working CTC panel without all that wiring hassle. Please let me know in the comment section below what you think about it. Hello YouTubers, and welcome to the Internet of Toy Trains. I'm Hans Tanner, and here is a new episode of IoTT with fresh ideas about how to use the Internet of Things along with sensors and microcontrollers to control a model railroad layout. So, get on board! The train is leaving the station. In recent years, we saw a remarkable development in LED technology. Light output went up to a point they can be used now to replace regular light bulbs, and prices per lumen of light output went from very expensive to dirt cheap. Furthermore, RGB light strips became available that make installation much easier because all the wiring is on the strip and all LEDs can be controlled individually using a serial interface. If you check out YouTube, you find several people building light panels and other interesting things using those strips. Also, being born and raised in Switzerland, I remembered the days when I went to the train station and had a look at the CTC panel there. In those days, the CTC panels were constructed using small squares with buttons and lamps arranged in a way to show tracks and signals and so on. This system from Integra, a Swiss company which later became part of Siemens Mobility, was called Domino. So I thought, what about building a CTC panel following this modular approach and using LED light strips with a constant spacing as light sources for track and position indicators? That's how I got started. The first step was designing the visible surface of the CTC panel. Using PowerPoint, I started by designing a grid with the spacing of 16.5 mm, which is the spacing of the LEDs on the light strip. I did a test printout to see if it fits the strip after printing and actually had to make a small adjustment. Then I designed the layout of the CTC using the grid as reference for the placement of the LEDs and buttons. I purchased an 11 by 15 size poster frame and replaced the glass by a thin plexiglass so that I could drill holes in it for the buttons, which of course have to go in between the light strips. Then I cut out the layout prints and put it in the frame. That's how in the end the CTC panel would look like. Not bad. Since minimizing the number of wires used for buttons and LEDs was one of my goals, I decided to use touch sensors as buttons. This way I only needed to run one wire to each button. I used copper rivets as touch points, drilled a hole through the plexiglass and soldered one wire to each of the buttons. I used wire wrap wires, which are very thin and can be run without problems from the buttons to the controller. For the indicator LEDs, I ran three strips with 25 LEDs each for track signaling and one strip for the switchblade position indicators. I used copper wires on the side for 5V and ground, and I arranged the direction of the strips to form a snake to minimize the length of the signal wire. I then used a 3mm hole punch to make the openings for the LED lights to shine through. The final layout sheet consists of several layers to make sure the LED light is somewhat diffused and to avoid LED light shining through the paper too much. First, I used two layers of blotter paper. In addition, I used two layers of masking tape directly above the light strips to further dim the light shining through the paper where it is not wanted. Next time, I probably will use electrical tape to even better block the light. Then I punched out the LED holes and finally I applied a layer of matte finished scotch tape as a light diffuser. To assemble, I first glued the rivet heads into the plexiglass plate. Then I ran the button wires through the layout paper and placed the layout paper on the plexiglass and inserted it into the frame. It is actually important to choose a frame that is loaded from the back. I do not know how this would work with a front-loaded frame. I then arranged the button wires so that they would run in between the LEDs and taped them down where needed. Then I cut some cardboard strips and mounted them in the areas where there are no LED strips. The idea is to make sure the layout paper is supported and slightly pressed against the plexiglass. Finally, I pushed the button wires through the center hole, going into the yellow controller box on the backside of the picture board, and inserted and secured the board in the frame. It started to look like a CTC panel. To control the CTC panel and communicate with the digital command control system, I developed this yellow box on the backside. Inside the yellow box, there is not much really. As controller, I am using an ESP32 programmed using the Arduino IDE. The main reason for using the ESP32 instead of the ESP8266 is that it features touch capabilities on 10 of the I/O pins. I am using an analog multiplexer, so I am only using one touch pin to support the 16 input lines available, from which just 10 are used on this panel. As I have plenty of I/Os left, I plan to probably use 4 touch inputs in future versions, which would give me 64 lines for touch buttons. The other thing I added is a LocoNet interface, so the device can be connected directly to LocoNet, but it can also receive commands from an MQTT broker, and in fact it can even act as LocoNet to MQTT gateway, as shown in video number 1, if configured accordingly. I will use the next few videos to discuss hardware and software of the yellow box in detail, so here is just a quick overview on the capabilities. The number of LEDs basically is not limited, for sure more than what you physically can place on the CTC panel. Currently, it has 16 buttons and I plan to support 64 as a standard. With some stretching, 128 would be possible. When connected to LocoNet, the yellow box can send switch commands as well as receive switch position and block detector messages from the network. When connected to Wi-Fi and an MQTT broker, it can send and receive these commands as well, plus it can send and receive button and status information from one CTC panel to another for coordination and remote control. The yellow box can also act as a LocoNet to MQTT gateway, of course only if connected to Wi-Fi and MQTT broker. On the Wi-Fi side, it supports access point mode or infrastructure mode. The configuration of block detector and switch position messages to LEDs and switch, route, signal activator buttons can be conveniently done using a web browser on a PC or mobile phone. The CTC panel supports true two-button operation for activation of routes, meaning two buttons need to be pressed and held to activate a route. Okay, I admit that not all of the above features are fully developed yet. Some are still experimental, but I will develop them over the next few weeks and provide update videos demonstrating those capabilities. So, let's just play with it for a few moments. Since it is based on a picture frame, I simply hang it next to the track and connect power. As I use MQTT, there is no other connection needed. Without MQTT working, I would have to connect LocoNet as well, but that's it. To me, this is particularly convenient as I am a garden railroader, so I can simply take my CTC panels out in the garden to play with the trains and have them stored in a safe place otherwise. I am using my Wi-Fi throttle here to run my consist of 2 locomotives on my test layout. First, let's just see what happens if I move the locos from Left City to Right Ridge. As expected, we see the track occupancy detectors coming up as the locos drive through the respective track section. Now I operate the switches using the toggle sensor on the switch plate. If you do not like the touch sensor buttons, you can also use a push button or even a regular level switch. The CTC panel inputs can handle touch, analog and digital input. As expected, the switch changes position and the new position is indicated on the switch plate and the track diagram. The same is the case if I operate the switch from somewhere else. and finally the two button route activation. I touch the sensor of the origin track and the sensor of the destination track at the same time for 1 second, and the configured route will be executed and indicated on the CTC panel. Then, when the train moves along the route, the position is shown and the lights go dark after the train passed. Looks like everything works as expected. So here is, as always, a quick summary of this video. Nowadays, LEDs are cheap and bright enough to be used as signal lights on CTC panels, even outdoors. LED strips come in lengths of up to 5 meters with an LED spacing of 16.5 millimeter. That is 300 LEDs on a strip, all of them individually controllable using just one wire and a serial protocol. A poster frame can be used as a carrier for a CTC panel. They are cheap and come in various sizes, so this methodology can be used for many different CTC panels that can be distributed on the layout and serve as local command input points. Touch buttons, as offered by the ESP32, are a nice option, but it is also possible to use conventional contacts or stylish switchblades. The finished CTC panel makes for quite an attractive eye-catcher in any layout room. That's at least what I think. Now, this was just a quick introduction showing how to build the panel. There is, of course, much more to say about the yellow box and how to configure it for a specific yard or layout. This is what I am going to cover in the next videos, so stay tuned. In case you are interested in building your own CTC panel, I posted a few links in the description section below from where you can download more information on LED strips and other topics. If you like this video, click that like button below and consider subscribing to the IoTT channel. Also, I am very interested to hear from you what functionality you would like to see supported by the CTC panel. Please let me know about your ideas in the comment section of this video. Thanks for watching and see you soon!